Today we will be moving one of our websites to an AWS server. In my previous tutorial, we saw how to launch an Ubuntu instance. We also configured Apache, MySQL, and PHP. We then added an SSL certificate to the instance. Now we're going to transfer our website over to this instance. Our site, we created it with Joomla, and then we archived it with Akiba Backup, and we will run the installation with Akiba Kickstart. The same process also applies if you're running a WordPress site. Akiba script that we're using, you know, is still available for both WordPress and Joomla sites. So the first thing to do to start is to connect to our AWS instance. All right, so now we're connected, and the next thing we should do is to cd into our HTML directory. Okay, great. And then now we're going to grab the actual JPA package which the Akiba backup created for us. And we're gonna do that right now, and we're using the wget command to grab all these files. And that's done. Great. So now that we are done with our terminal commands, we are now back on Chrome browser, and we go to the domain and we go straight to the kickstart.php file, and this will load this page. And as you can see, it has already selected our JPA package that we grabbed earlier on. So let's just go ahead and click start to unpack this archive. All right, great. So once you see this page, it means that everything has gone well so far. So the next thing we do, we click on run the installer. Right, and this will open up this page for us, and you can see that everything is on green. If they are not on green, you can go back and check your PHP ini file and see if you can make some changes. We are lucky, we've got all our settings correct, so let's go ahead. And here we enter our database information on this page. The server host is usually localhost. Alright, and I think that's pretty much it for this page. And yes, we want to drop the tables if there's any in there. And you could force collection of your databases, but for this instance we don't need to do that right now, so let's go ahead to the next step. And if you see this, that means that the database is beginning to unpack and install, so this is a good sign. All right, that's great. Okay, a good tip, always check this. Okay, and we click next. All right, so on this page it tells you that we've completed the setup, so we can close this tab and we go back to the other tab and click on cleanup, and this will now delete the kickstart PHP and also the installation folder of Joomla. And if we click on the front end, we should be able to access the site. There you go. So we have the site up and running, and that's about it. And the one final thing that I usually like to do is to go to my phpMyAdmin and open the database and just do an optimize, and that'll be it. Optimize the tables, Right, so that's done. And that's pretty much it. So thank you very much for joining me this time around, and have a great day. Bye. Thank you very much for watching. If you found this useful, please give it a like or share it. You can subscribe if you want to see more of my tutorials. If you have any questions relating to this or your website, AWS, or maybe you just want to hire me or just want to say hello, the best way to reach me is via social media or WhatsApp. All the details are in the description below.